I wonder what the fox would say if he had the opportunity to create a video using Apple's Clips. This app is amazing, and I can't wait to share with you how you can use it to create something and share your learning with others.
To begin with the Clips app by Apple, tap on it, and that's going to bring up this screen. And that screen's gonna give you the camera pointed at you or whomever is recording. And you can see up here, there's your little flip down. So if I flip it that way, it's gonna give me a black screen because I have my case cover on. So the first thing I wanna add to my video is what we call a poster in the Clips app. And the poster is your introduction to your video. So you can scroll through and kind of see which poster you would like to use. I like to use the abstract ones because they're moving ones. So I'm gonna use this red one, and you'll see it has Let's Do This on it, but you can get rid of that and create it into any words that you want just by tapping. And that brings up your keyboard, and you can just delete and type in any words that you would like for the title of your video. Once you have your title typed, and since we're using this for Math Snaps, let's go ahead and type in Math Snaps 24 Challenge and then just your first name. There's two different ways that you can do to get rid of this wording. You can either tap on your get rid of the keyboard key, or you can tap on apply. So either one of those is going to take you back to the main screen again. Now you'll notice down here you still don't have anything in your video. That's because you have to actually press on hold on this pink button in order to get the video to video. And I want you to watch right up in here. You're going to see a counter coming down, and we want to tap and hold this pink button until that counter gets to about 3 or 4 seconds, because that's a good intro for our video. So here we go. We're going to tap and hold, and you can see that counter going down, and right when you get to about 3 or 4 seconds, you can let go. And when you tap on this play button, that play button is going to show you what it looks like.
And you can see that counter going down, and
now I don't want my voice in this introduction, so I'm going to tap right here where this little video is down in my video line, and I'm going to go ahead and mute it so that you don't hear my voice. And then you can see that there's all these different other effects that we can do. We can trim it and make it shorter. We can save this clip alone. We can go ahead and add some effects here, and those are where you can add some labels or some stickers. These are the ones too, you know, me and my Star Wars stickers. So you can move your stickers around. You can size them by pinching. You can add more stickers, and you'll see how it layers it. And again, you can size it around. Let's see, we'll go ahead and add the TIE Fighter up here, and we'll put that on Darth's side. And so once you have all of that done, you tap on this X, and that X will take you back. And again, you can play it by tapping on your play button. And now you can't hear my voice as I'm talking, but you can definitely see what your introduction is gonna look like. Down here in the timeline, you can see that we have that one video. So now we're gonna add a picture that we've taken. And I'm gonna go ahead and add in this picture that I've taken of Winston in front of the mailbox, because these are our Math Snaps. And you can resize it, you can zoom it in. Again, that pinch and pull kind of gives you an idea of where you are. So once you have the picture set up the way you want it, you can tap on this effects. And this effects again is gonna give you the ability to change the filter. So this is where I can bring in that comic book type look, so that it kind of gives it a comic look. I can do an aged film look, I can do a vivid look. There's tons of filters here that you can choose. I think I'm gonna stick with just the original for right now. And then I'm gonna take a look at this label. And as you go through the labels, I'm gonna kind of look for one that might have something that would have Winston thinking of something in this math snap. Now again with the labels, if I tap, I can change that wording and type in my own words. So here's the wording that I changed it to, and I might even add another arrow right up here that has a significance to pointing out where that mailbox is. And again, you can go in and add some stickers. If you wanted to add some stickers, you could circle your mailbox. You could highlight your mailbox. And if you decide you don't want one, if you tap on it, you can see that little X right there. Tap on that X and it'll go away. Again, you can use your finger to pinch and pull. If you just want that to pinch and pull, make sure that you have tapped on it. Because if you tap on the whole picture, that's going to pinch and pull the whole picture and change the whole image that you have. So wherever you tap, that's what you're going to be moving. Once you have all of the effects added in, you still have not added this particular image into your video lineup. Again, you're going to hold on that pink button, and I would suggest, since this is a mass snap, letting this one for 5 seconds. So you'll see that countdown up at the top, and you'll see it counting to five, and when you let go, now you can see it's down here. And again, to get rid of my voice or any voice that's going on, all you need to do is tap on that mute. If I wanted to change the effects, I can change the effects or add more effects in. And again, I can click on this X to get rid of it, and then I'm ready to move on to the next step. So to move on to the next step and add something new, I can tap on camera, and that camera is going to be able to give me the ability to add in my own little video of what I'm expecting. So now that I have these clips finished and I have everything affected and all of that, I want to click on the done button and go back to the posters, and I want to choose one that would be the ending of my poster. So I might choose, since I'm in that Star Wars mode, to have R2-D2 be that person. And I need to go ahead and get this speaker off, the live title, so I can tap on the none, and that'll take off the live title. So once you have all four of your pieces added into your video, you want to go back and tap on the very first piece of your video, and then you can add sound if you'd like to, some background music, by tapping on this musical note and going to soundtracks. And then from soundtracks, you can kind of take a look through and see which ones you would like. Again, you want to be careful because it can get pretty loud, but you can listen to it. And if you like it, you tap on this red dot up here, and that just takes it back and says, I'm going to apply that to the entire video. And you tap on apply, and now your music is on your whole video. And it will just keep looping through the entire video.
How many ways can you solve for 24 with Winston's numbers? I look forward to seeing what you create.
So now that you have your video all put together, you want to save it to the camera roll by tapping on this square with the arrow, and you want to save your video, and it will download that video and let you know when it's in your camera roll.
So that's how easy it is to create a video with the Apple Clips app.